let's discuss about the mean value and RMS value of AC current. So as I have already told you that in an AC cycle, when the AC current that moves in a sinusoidal curve, the maximum value, or also if we think as electromagnetic wave, this is called as electromagnetic wave. So the amplitude, that is the maximum value of this wave, is like this, which we have called the maximum value. Same way for the current, AC current, we have called I naught as the maximum current, where I, the instantaneous current, is I naught sine omega t, and the voltage, instantaneous voltage, is V naught, the maximum value of voltage, into sine omega t. Right? So when we talk about this, either this gives us the maximum value and this gives us the instantaneous value. But when we talk about the overall the voltage of AC current, or the AC current voltage, or the current of alternating current, then we either talk about the mean value or the RMS value of the current or the voltage. Now, if I have to talk about, first let's look at the mean current or mean voltage. If I have to talk about the mean, it means that it is the average of all over cycle. So the cycle starts and this is a full cycle. So it goes, comes down, and this. So this is a full cycle. And generally, if we take an average of either current or voltage over a full cycle, you see the first half of the cycle it's positive and the second half of the cycle it's negative. And therefore, if I take average, what happens? We get a value, average value is zero. So therefore, if I have to talk about the current average over the full cycle, this is the full cycle, I call it as T. The half cycle, I call it as T half. The full cycle, why I call it as T? Because T is the time period. Time period means time needs to, the time that needs for the one full cycle is the time period. So if time period is T, for the half cycle, the time is T by 2, or T half. So if I take the average over the full cycle, generally either the current, this is the symbol of average, so either the current or the voltage over the full cycle becomes zero, as it is it changes its direction and the value also keeps changing, and therefore the average over the full cycle is zero. So therefore, whenever we are talking about the mean value or the average value of the AC current or voltage, we have to talk about the average in the half cycle. So we talk about the half cycle and we take an average. So here, that's how I have taken the current average at T half, for the half. So here we are integrating I dt, which is from the integration goes from 0 to t half, because we are taking the limit from the 0 till the t half, only half cycle, not the full cycle, divided by the total time from 0 to t half. So average means, suppose if I have to take average of 5 subjects, so what I do, I take the total number of addition of all the numbers of all the 5 subjects and then divide by 5. So same way, here we have taken the integration of all the current divided by the total time of the current. And if I do that, here I get t half. So here little bit of integration is there, which you need to be little careful about. So integration 0 to t half, so this goes here, and from here we are doing 0 to t half. I here is I naught sine omega t, so here I naught sine omega t dt divided by 0 to t half dt. So when you do this integration, therefore I naught is constant, and when you do this integration, the integration becomes I naught as it's constant, and this whole integration of 0 to t half sin omega t dt divided by dt, this is a kind of constant integration, known integration. So I directly put the value, which is 2 by pi. So my average or the mean current of t half becomes 2 by pi into I naught. You see, so this whole term of the average, I naught is constant, and the whole term gives me 2 by pi. So the average value is 2 by pi times of the maximum value. And this 2 by pi, if I just substitute in numerical, then I get 0.637 I naught, right? So this is the average over the half cycle, which is 0.637 times of the I naught. It means that the 63% or approximately, this is the 63% of the maximum value that we talk, or that we call it as the mean value or the average value of the AC current or AC voltage. Same way we can also write as 2 by pi times of V naught, or EMF, if I take, this is 2 by pi times of E naught. So this is always the mean value, always in AC, gives us the 63% or 0.637 times of the maximum current or maximum voltage or maximum EMF. Now talking about to RMS value, why we generally we do this this kind of calculation? Because our instruments, like a very normal instruments like ammeter or a galvanometer or voltmeter, it needs to show the deflection. But if I take the average over the whole thing, over the whole cycle, this instruments doesn't show the kind of deflection that we talk about. So therefore, for all the calculation purpose, all the kind of experiment purpose, we either have to depend on the mean value, or there is another finer more calculation, which we call it as RMS value or root mean square value. So here already we have spoke about the mean value or the average value. Now we talk about the mean square and the root of it. It means that suppose I take this I square and then I do the mean of I squares, all the squares, and we take mean of that, and then we root, take the root of the mean of the squares of the value. So this is called RMS value. So first we take the squares and then mean it. So this, but this we will do over the full cycle. Normal mean we do only for half cycle, whereas the RMS values we can do over the full cycle, because we are taking I square value. So even the squares always we don't have any problem when we take a square of the quantity. So 0 to t I square dt, and the mean when we do the I squares, mean 0 to 2 dt. So this is the mean of I square. So when I just substitute, this become I naught square sine square omega t dt divided by integration of dt 0 to t, both integration goes from 0 to t in both sides. So this becomes I naught square is a constant, it just comes out, and integration over 0 to t sin square omega t dt divided by 0 to t integration over dt, this whole thing becomes actually 1 by root 2. This is I naught square by, this becomes by 2. Half. So, this is the integration value. Now, we have to do the root of the square of the mean. So, we have done the square, mean of the squares. Now, we have to do root of that. So, we get IRMS, which is the root of I naught square by 2. And therefore, I get I naught by root 2. So, this is the IRMS. So, this is the RMS value, or root mean square value, which is the 1 by root 2 times of the maximum value, which is I naught. And if I just put it in numerical, this can go as 0.707 I naught. So therefore, what we see, that root mean square value, or RMS value, is approximately the 70% of the maximum value of the AC current or AC voltage. So same way, we can write VRMS is kind of 0.707 I naught, and as well as if I take RMS is also 0.707 E naught, right? So these are the RMS value, which are actually very, very important when we do any kind of calculation. So what we saw, that RMS values are 1 by root 2 times or 0.707 times of the maximum current or maximum voltage or maximum EMF. And mean values are 2 by pi times or 63% or 0.67 times of the maximum values of the current as well as the voltages as well as the EMF. And therefore, the mean value of current, or the average value of current, and the RMS value of current or RMS value of voltage, it's very, very important. And generally, this, many times, this is RMS value is also called the virtual value of the current or the voltage. Now, one more thing, as we know, the VRMS, the RMS voltage of our day-to-day appliances are generally 220 volt. So, from here, I can get the maximum voltage that we use in our day-to-day life is root 2 times of 220 volt, which is 311 volt. So this is a very interesting thing to know, that in India, in our day-to-day appliances, maximum goes for the maximum voltage value is 311 volt. Now, one more very interesting thing is the ratio of these two, VRMS by Vmean, or the RMS current by mean current. This is what is called specifically the VRMS by V mean is what is called the form factor, FF. This form factor is the ratio of the VRMS by Vm. So if I just plug in, VRMS is V naught by root 2, and V mean is 2 by pi into V naught, then we can say that this is V naught gets cancelled, and this becomes pi by 2 root 2, and the value is 1.11. so the form factor is a very, very important ratio, which value is generally 1.11. Generally, when we try to make certain circuits, and we there are people who electricals and engineers, electrical engineers and all, when they try to make certain appliances or certain circuits, this form factor becomes very important, as to this indicates if the current or the appliance's current will work for it or not. So therefore, RMS value, mean value, and the form factor is very important when we talk about AC currents.
If you like the video, then press the like button, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon.